Welcome to COA on the Air, a television show for the seniors in Bedford, educating, informing, interesting topics. I'd like to introduce my co-host, Lester Macklin. Hi, Lester.
Hi, Leslie.
How are you?
I'm okay, but you know what? I'm getting tired.
Oh.
Yeah, there are things I can't do anymore.
You're getting too young, Lester.
That's true. So, there is, in Bedford, a group that can help me, or you, or anybody else over the age of 65.
Let me guess.
It's called
Willard at Home, yeah.
Right. And with us today, we have the program director, Paula Van Kledorf, and also a member of the board, Adele Purvis. So welcome.
Hi.
Thank you.
Welcome, ladies.
Yes.
Thank you.
We had a conversation yesterday, and I learned so much. There are so many things that I would like somebody to do for me. And to do that, I have to hire somebody or find somebody to hire them for me. And that's what At Home does.
It certainly is one of the things we do.
Right.
Yeah,
it would keep me at home, and I could relax, and I wouldn't have to worry about it.
Put your feet up and let us do all the worrying. Yep.
Okay.
So why don't you start by telling us what Carleton Willard At Home is?
Okay. So we are a not-for-profit organization affiliated with Carleton Willard Village, which most people in Bedford who are over a certain age are at least aware of. We are just starting this week our eighth year of operations.
Wow.
So we've been around
for eight years.
And we do a variety of different things. The thing that Lester is referring to, which we call our preferred service providers, are a group of about 110 different providers. They include plumbers and electricians and carpenters and all the kind of people that would come and work on your home. We also sort of think of the people who come inside your home, so not that plumbers and electricians don't, but cleaning people and organizers and someone to fix your computer, things like that. And then we also work with local home health care agencies to bring home care in if you're in a situation where you've come home from the hospital, you've just had your hip replaced or something, and taking a shower might be tricky or getting in and out of bed. So we have the whole, what we kind of think of as the spectrum, and if you need something that we haven't thought of, then we will go out and try and find that for you.
So in other words, if I want to stay at home and I need help, I call you and we figure it out.
And it can be, you know, just about anything you need. One of the other things that we do is our meal delivery program, which is called Gourmet to Go.
I love it.
These are the same meals that are cooked in the main dining room at Carleton Willard.
For those of you that don't know, I've eaten there.
Right.
The food is really good. It's really good.
Yeah.
And have
just,
you eaten there?
I'm going to.
Yeah. In about 2 seconds. The meals, when we deliver them, are flash frozen. And they come in a plastic microwavable container, and we bring them right to your door once a week. You can order as many or as few as you want, and it follows the menu at Carleton Willard, the same menu in the dining room.
And that's only $10.
And they're $10
really?
Delivered to your house,
whoa.
Which is a pretty good deal.
That's a great deal.
And we thought that you might just like to taste a couple of the ones that were on the menu for today, so we brought along a little sample.
Thank you.
So that one is a swordfish with a tomato-based topping and gemelli and obviously carrots. And the other one is one of our members' all-time favorite staples, ordered whenever it appears up, is mashed potatoes and meatloaf with a mushroom sauce. We also brought along two soups. So we do entrees. The entree comes like this. Well, it doesn't come on this beautiful plate, but it comes like this with two side dishes. So that's $10 delivered to your house. The soups, which come in 12-ounce containers, are $4 delivered. That one is a cauliflower and apple soup. And the other one is basic chicken noodle.
Mm. So it's a Meals on Wheels that tastes good,
Exactly. It's a high-end Meals on Wheels.
Great.
And interestingly, you know, we have members who order two or three or four probably every week, keep them in their freezer, they get home at night, and you know, they're not feeling so well, they don't want to bother to cook, they can just pop them in. We have people who go in and out of sort of ordering. They might have been in the hospital for a little while, they come home, cooking starts to look like a real chore for a while, so they'll order maybe six or eight meals.
You don't have to be a senior citizen to appreciate this, let me tell you. Working people, so, this is good too.
My favorite story is that we had a couple who, the woman had a hip replacement. Mm-hmm. And she called me up and she says, Paula, she said, my husband cannot cook. Oh. And so for the time that she was rehabbing, she got 14 meals a week. One for her, wow. One for him, for every day.
That.
And then once she was back to being up and about again.
She's cooking.
She's cooking, and she doesn't order it.
So what if I have special dietary needs?
Well, if it's very, very specific dietary needs, like really specific allergies and stuff. In fact, one of our members, who is a neighbor of Adele's in Huckins Farm, has all sorts of allergies. So he works with the nutritionist at Carleton Willard to identify the meals on our menu that are acceptable and suitable for him to eat. And anybody who's really working on a very specialized diet, we match them up with her to make sure that they know exactly what they can order.
It's good.
That's excellent. This soup is great.
Yeah. My favorite meal.
Meatloaf.
Meatloaf.
You told me that. That's why I brought it last night.
Cracker Barrel makes one, too.
So how many people are participating?
In the meals, yes. The meal program, we generally deliver between 50 and 70 meals a week.
That's a lot.
It's a lot. And, you know, we cover six towns, and so
Six towns?
Yeah, so we cover...
Oh, I didn't know that.
Concord, Carlisle, Bedford, Lexington, Lincoln, and Winchester. So we fan out on Tuesday afternoons to all six towns and deliver the meals.
And I'm assuming you ask for feedback?
We do, and generally...
And calibrate to that.
And people are... Very honest. You know, some things they like better than others, and you can the menu goes on a 5-week cycle, and so let's say Lester's a member and he happens to love meatloaf, so he knows that every 5 weeks that meatloaf's going to show up again.
So and I can order two and put one.
You can
in
absolutely.
The
you could order
one.
Seven if you want.
And right. Say you could order 12.
So
I can see this being pretty handy.
Yeah,
it is very handy.
And you like what you have? This is very good.
Good.
This
is
great.
I love it.
It's great at Carleton Willard.
Can I take home what's left?
You certainly may.
Bring a doggy bag?
Yeah.
Okay. Carleton Willard at home is not free.
No, it's not.
It does have a cost for either individuals or couples. Mm-hmm. And $6.45.
For an individual, yeah.
And $9.10.
For a household.
For a household. Mm-hmm. A household could be more than two.
Well, occasionally we've had some members who have been a couple with a disabled child or something like that that's living at home with them. And we don't, especially, what are you going to say, well, who's going to eat which meal? You know, we don't worry about that kind of thing. So
that's a wonderful usage for people.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm getting tired of cutting the lawn. And I'd like to have somebody do it, but you know, who do I get? So at least if you go to at home, they pretty much ensure that the person is safe, reliable, and so on.
So how do you find your people?
So when we started, we began to put together a list, mostly from recommendations and have people that said, oh, you know, you should use Joe the plumber or whomever. And over the 8 years, we've honed it down, thrown out the dead weight, and then occasionally someone will come to us and say, oh, you know, they'll join. Usually it's a new member and say, oh, I love my handyman or I love my whomever. And then we will vet them and they fill out an application and we do a COA check on them.
You do a full check.
We do a full check.
That's
and,
good.
You know, now almost all of them we've used. And so I feel very comfortable. When I was selling my house in Carlisle a couple years ago, I used a number of our providers to help me get it ready to sell. And I left the door open, came to work, and they just came and went.
Wow.
And I never worried
about
it.
That's saying something. And have you used the services, Adele?
I have. I have used some of the meal deliveries at various times, and we've been very pleased. It has come in very handy. Two of the things that the at-home provides that are covered in the annual membership fee are transportation to medical appointments that I have appreciated very much. If I were to have an appointment for myself or for my husband, it, even though I'm able to drive to Leahy Clinic, it is a large medical facility, and if my husband is not feeling that well, I don't have to drop him off and go find a place mm-hmm. to park and leave him. I'm able just to have the driver drop us right off in front of the facility, and I can go upstairs with my husband. Another feature
that's at no cost.
That is included on an unlimited basis at this point, in the annual membership fee.
That's excellent. That's actually excellent.
That has been wonderful. And something that we have not used, but I'm definitely keeping it on the back burner, is that the membership fee also includes a food shopping trip mm-hmm. with the member once a week throughout the course of the year. And I often do the shopping, and I'm thinking if I were laid up or were not able to get out, a neighbor will always say, do you need something from the store? I'll pick it up for you. But there is a benefit if a person cannot get out to be able to go to the store themselves. And my understanding of the program is that a driver would pick me up or my husband and drive them to a local food store.
And you can name them. Stop and Shop.
Stop and, yeah, I mean.
Market Basket.
I like Whole Food. I live a mile and a half away, and I'm used to shopping there. And I like the idea that I could, if I see something in the store that appeals to me when I'm there, I can
especially if you're hungry,
it. And for my husband, right, to drive me home. And I think so far we've talked about the basic activities of daily living. And just a week ago, the at-home program, Paula and her staff send out a monthly newsletter with information on all of the available activities, as well as a couple of health articles and enrichment opportunities. And the most recent mailing that we received included an announcement of the availability of a gardener who tends some of the special gardens at Carleton Willard, who had some time and would
gardener.
Be happy. So I contacted this man, and he came just last week to my, we have our general landscaping is taken care of in the community where I live at Huckins Farm, but other plantings that we've put in over the years that I'm beginning to look askance at because it is now more maintenance than I want to deal with. He will be coming in a couple of weeks, and we'll be pruning and taking away and cleaning up our garden and putting it to bed for the winter. And there are also wonderful cultural activities, and that was one of the things that hooked me. I had been thinking of the at-home program. We're starting our third year of membership now. And I had tracked at-home programs for a number of years in the area, and many of them were volunteer-driven organizations in Beacon Hill and Brookline and other areas in the Boston area. And when the at-home program of Carleton Willard was first offered, I was really attracted to it because of the scaffolding and the whole organization of Carleton Willard Village behind it, that it's a professional organization that has longevity and competence, and we had a lot of confidence in the village itself. And I'm a retired occupational therapist, and that's important for me to know that the people who I would be bringing into our home for support have been vetted and are supervised and would be people whom we might trust.
Yeah, you mentioned social things. There's a 300-seat theater there.
I've been
to auditorium.
Carleton, well, it's awesome. Wow. I've been to the theater. It's a beautiful theater. They've had some pretty sophisticated concerts.
Yeah.
And is that what you're referring to, that anything that happened to Carleton?
Well, one of my neighbors had let me know that he had joined about 2 years ago. I think he was joining for a variety of the same reasons that I was interested in, but he also let me know that at-home members are able to ride on the van from the village to the Friday afternoon matinees of the Boston Symphony.
Oh, how nice.
So we're starting our third season this fall, driving 5 minutes from our home and just getting on the van, and it drops us right off in front of Symphony Hall. We can have a wonderful lunch.
Now, I'm assuming that's additional purchase.
Yeah, it's a ten.
It
it's
is.
$10.
It's a nominal. $10.
It's $10.
$10
just for that
round trip.
Yeah, that's nothing.
Per person.
That's nothing.
And there are special monthly trips for at-home members that we've taken.
Nice.
Yeah. So we had one.
One of the things we've sort of found over the 8 years, and Adele is a marvelous example of having sort of taken really good advantage of the integration, is when we began, the village, Carleton Willard Village, was sort of here, and we were a separate entity, and we didn't really integrate our services other than they were behind us, as Adele explained. But we found over the time that the residents at Carleton Willard Village love having the at-home program because they have friends who are part of at-home. And as time has progressed, we've integrated more and more of our activities so that our members can take advantage of stuff that takes place at Carleton Willard. The symphony van, the van to the Huntington Theater, any of the concerts and lectures that happen at Carleton Willard, the at-home people are welcome to come to as well. So for our members who are on the younger and much more sprightly end, which is certainly where Adele falls, there is a subset of things that are engaging in a way that isn't what we do with our older members. I mean, our oldest member, I was telling Lester, is 102. So needless to say, and our youngest member is 67. So you've got different people accessing it at different moments in the aging process. Mm-hmm. And what Adele and Jim want is very different than what our 102-year-old want. They want the expertise in the healthcare and perhaps the access to Carleton Willard at some point if they need skilled nursing and that kind of thing, whereas we have another subset who take advantage of the social activities and things like that.
Now, are you creating the substance to the programs? Was this your idea to integrate Carleton Willard into the at-home?
Well, it sort of just evolved over time.
Because I find Carleton Willard has a history of being very creative in its services.
And you know, I think that a lot of, if you look at the sort of the movement of at-home type programs, mm-hmm. Most of them are very grassroots based. They're not originally affiliated with a bricks and mortar institution. But as time has progressed, they've found that it's difficult to be self-sustaining and that this sort of integration with an institution that can provide some of the care further down the road. Everybody loves to think they can stay home forever. That's what everybody wants. But sometimes
I don't want that.
Okay, well.
I got a planned entrance into Carleton Willard at X age.
Okay, well, good.
You want
to stay at home?
Yeah, all right, so for Lester, he wants to stay at home. We'll support him, but at some moment it might become clear that he needs a little extra help than what we can provide.
Like tomorrow.
And then we have the joy of having Carleton Willard behind us to do that. So we've just melded together more and more as time has gone on, and it's become a really interesting model. And Barbara Doyle gets calls from continuing care retirement communities around the country saying, how can we do this? And I get calls from at-home programs around the country saying, how can we do this from your end? And it's certainly evolving in that direction.
For our audience, Barbara is the CEO,
CEO, that's right.
Carleton Willard. So what services would you, food you made clear.
Oh, food, yeah, it's very
good. Someone to cut your lawn. What else is on the list of snow plowing, right?
Snow plowing, changing the light bulb that I can't reach now. Yeah. I need a ladder. I don't get on ladders anymore. Cleaning the gutters.
Gutters, you know,
it's very important.
Yeah.
But one other thing that we haven't spoken about is there is a connection with the COA and Carleton Willard at home. We have food in our cafeteria.
Yeah, that actually doesn't come from the at-home program. That comes from the village.
It's all from one area, right?
Yeah.
Right. And it's wonderful.
Although we sometimes lend our driver to help bring it over.
So what advice would you have for someone that's contemplating researching the service?
About joining at home?
Correct.
Well, I think that if we look at what has happened over the 8 years, we have about 260 members now. And we often get people who join when they have a crisis. They
that
can't drive
sense.
Any
Wait,
longer.
You're nodding. Was that your situation?
No, it was not. But I think what you're saying is resonating very strongly.
So,
I think
it makes a lot of sense.
All of a sudden
yeah.
you can't drive, or you've got
can't
a really
cook.
Complicated health issue, or you need home care, or you need food because you're not going to cook anymore, or you need transportation of one sort or another. And while we are happy to take you at that moment in time, we really prefer to have people like Adele who join before there's a crisis need. There may be a perceived need, mm-hmm. but then we get to know you. You're part of the family. Mm-hmm. We feel comfortable. We get to know the family sometimes, and therefore, when and if something starts to need extra care, we're in an ability to seamlessly jump in there and sort of keep you going.
It sounds exceptionally personalized, is it?
It is.
That's amazing to me.
I think you probably have a certain number in the membership that you see as looking at the numbers of people who use services, some who use more, some who use less. But the opportunity has always been there. If I contact Paula, her availability is extremely flexible, and she's very prompt in coming back. I think the reason that I was nodding when Paula had said people will put off, I don't really need this right now. I think having been on the other side of the fence in my career, I have seen that from a healthcare perspective where mm-hmm. families will say, well, I don't really need this right now. But make decision making at a time of crisis is a very, very
it's
difficult process.
It's an insurance.
And
it is.
To be able to think through and evaluate a goodness of fit with a program such as this, I think my husband and I have learned a lot about using the program and tapping resources that we wouldn't have thought of before.
Sure.
So it's not just insurance as in an insurance policy, but it benefits us to go to the symphony 8 or 9 times a year.
I was thinking
we
that.
We get out. I would not ordinarily want to face the idea of driving mm-hmm. into town, finding a place to park, leaving my husband, facing the drive home. This is a treat for me and for him. And my husband is 14 years older than I. So we are in slightly different at various times. We're all up and down at different times.
Mm-hmm.
But we know that we have the program supporting us at times that we need. And I also think that, and I've told Paula this in the past, that if we did need home care services on an emergency basis, the fact that I can call Paula and not have to start interviewing individually agencies, she can moderate that. And if there's any issue of a goodness of fit, I can contact her when I need to be supporting my spouse or my spouse would need to support me.
Well, you know, you've constantly gone back to people that need extra care, but I'm thinking I have a full-time job. And I also live at Huckins Farm, so we don't have to maintain our houses
That's
completely,
right.
but there's still a lot of maintenance. It's hard to find someone. Mm-hmm. It's hard to check them. I'm busy.
Right.
And cooking, not my favorite thing to do.
Right.
When my parents were at home, we tried to, they don't live in this state, but we tried to get them a food service. And we got them a couple, but the food wasn't any good.
Yeah.
They couldn't stand it.
And then
so they were
not
forced
eating.
To cook. So then I would go down there and cook 3 months worth of meals and stack the freezer. But it was a constant pull on everybody's resources. Mm-hmm. We didn't have a solution. Yeah. So I'm thinking this has
great.
Wide applications. Absolutely.
Yeah.
And 200, I'm surprised you don't have more members, but well, do people know about it? Because I didn't know you were doing the food.
Well,
that's why we're here.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lester. You know, we have 250, 260 members, and it, you know, it waxes and wanes in the sense that we've maintained that. We generally add somewhere between 30 and 50 new members a year, memberships,
that's
which can be more, is more people. But, you know, people's circumstances change. They might move into assisted living. Some of them move into Carleton Willard. We do have an arrangement with Carleton Willard such that if my members find that they are going to need extra care and they would like to come to Carleton Willard, there's certainly no pressure for that, I will work with the administration at Carleton Willard to try and help them find the right place there if that's what they want. But we're fairly comfortable with the number. You talked about personalized service, and if anybody asks me what I think we do best, that is what I think we do best. My drivers, and Mike, who's my main driver, who Adele knows well, we know everybody. We know them personally. When they call up, we can chat. We know their health circumstances. He knows everything because he's always driving them back and forth to the doctor. And we get very intricately involved in people's lives and can support them. So we don't want 500 members because to me, the gem of the program would probably dissipate if we got too big. So we kind of like it.
That makes a lot of sense.
It does.
Yeah.
I agree.
Yeah.
We're almost out of time. Any closing comments, either one of you, to our audience?
I think if a person were thinking about joining and were in a position similar to you, and I happen to be retired, but I retired younger to enjoy time with my husband, I think considering a membership in this program sooner rather than later, and I'm not saying that as an advertisement for the program, but I think it would benefit the member.
Quality of life.
The quality of life is a preventive, health-maintaining support. The support for maintaining a good quality of life comes from participating in the program sooner rather than later.
And I'll close with the food was really good.
And so here this comes is dessert.
Oh, good. What a great way to end this show.
The dessert.
We do provide desserts as well. They're not quite as healthy as our meals, but they are very tasty.
They look good. So we're going to have a little party afterwards. This is COA on the Air. Making friends, connecting. Thank you all for joining us.